Using EdTech tools in your online or in-person classes can take your teaching game up a notch or two. I am so excited for you to meet Natalie today. She's got 5 EdTech tools for us that will help us really engage our students and help them enjoy our classes that much more. I've left them all timestamped below, so if you're looking for one in particular, go ahead and head there. And stick around to the end because that's all I'm gonna say. That's the bloops for this week. All right, see you out there.
And I feel like I've actually known you a lot longer because about a year ago, your video was recommended to me so I could learn about one of my favorite tools, Nearpod. So anyway, give us a little intro. Who are you? Let us know a little bit about you.
Thank you for having me, Melissa. I'm super excited to be here. So my journey with technology, it started way back when I was in the classroom. I taught a special education resource, so students with mild to moderate disabilities. And I was in the classroom for 5 years. And while I was in there, I got my EdTech endorsement. So I took extra classes to learn all things technology because I needed different ways to engage my students. And you could just see, even like way back then, the technology is just an interest to students and they love it. And they love like the instant gratification of that those activities can offer. So I learned all the things and now taught English online and now I teach math online, which I love, is my focus. And just implementing all the fun like technology tools into the online teaching, it is so cool because I love, it's like so much more technology than in a physical classroom. So it's been fun. Awesome.
Oh my gosh. I love it. Okay. Well, cool. Well, I am a tech fan, but I am learning so much from you and I love how you share that on your accounts and stuff. And so, tell us, you've told us a little bit of why EdTech. So talk to us a little bit about some of the tools that you love. I know we love Nearpod. I know there's a few others that a lot of online teachers are going to know, but you've got a few that I'm not that familiar with. And I bet some of our people listening might not be as well. So give us your like top 5, if you would. What do you love in terms of EdTech?
So top 5, and I use all of these in a variety of my classes. I love Nearpod. Number 1, I use Google Slides a lot, Canva, games. And games I've created and game sites that that you can use. And Google Sheets is a really fun one. And I know that one, like I saw your face, that one like scares accounting? People away.
That's where my financials go.
yes, exactly. But it's so cool to create like self-checking activities where they, you know, type in an answer and it goes green if it's right, or the box turns red if it's wrong. So it's really cool. So those are my top 5. I guess we'll start back with Nearpod. So Nearpod is a great like all-in-one site. It has it all. You can create your slides and then add in those interactive activities like a matching game, virtual field trip. So those 360 images, there are 3D images and all these are movable. Students are just like in awe.
Like I use this in a class of 6 kids and all 6 are spinning the globe trying to find the continent we're talking about or something like that.
Yes. So, yeah. Yep. On their own. Yes. On their own terms. It's so cool. Cause then they kind of get a, and like learn on their own. But yeah, you're still doing it as a group.
A lot of times online, it's like, hi, children, here is the material. Learn it. You know, it's not as fun, not as engaging. So cool.
Yeah. Nearpod is a fantastic tool for that. And it's just so easy to add in all the interactivity, which helps you stand out as a teacher. Students love your classes. So then they're like drawn, I want more classes with you because they're so fun and memorable. So Nearpod's a great tool for that.
And just in case people are curious, do we have to pay for Nearpod? Do kids have to pay for Nearpod?
No, it is free. It's a really cool free tool. And there's so many features for free. Usually you have to like, you know, you only have access for so long for free, or you can only do this X amount for free. This is like all of it for free for teachers. It's awesome. And students, they don't need to pay for it. They don't even need an account. you are just able to teach this lesson to them and they're on their own device, or not. It works either way. They can participate.
I just taught one this morning where one kid was like, he was camping. He was in a tent, Natalie, taking class. And I was like, all right, I'm going to share my screen and my sound today and you can watch what I'm doing on your pod. But like, there's a lot that you can do, but basically you just send the link and a code and I just send it in the chat. So that's great. Yep. Okay. Rocking. Yep. So free Nearpod. We love it. Fantastic. What else?
Yeah. All my tools are free that I'm talking about today, actually. So Google Slides. Google Slides are an amazing platform. You can do so much and go beyond like your basic slide deck, slide presentation. You can create games. My favorite is, I call it hide and seek. So like picture a scene like you created. So we'll stick with camping, for example. So you create this picture and you add pictures of like a tent, your campers, trees. So you add all these images and then you hide questions behind the images. So when you share your screen and click on an image, it will disappear and ta-da, there's a question to answer. And then you click on it again and it will hide it again with the picture.
Oh my gosh.
So it's super, I love that. Yeah.
This is just animating objects. I'm trying to like think, how does this work? So it's an image, you've got questions on it.
Actually, it's not animated. It's, you have to link slides together. Yes. So there are like lots of slides together. So when you click it, it looks like magic, but it's taking you to another slide. And then you go back. It's really cool. And it looks like it just disappears. It's cool. Oh, it's like magic.
There you go. Now so. I know why. The EdTech wizard. There we go. That's why. Oh my gosh. Okay. So, and I can imagine, you know, 8,000 ways that we could use this. I mean, this is you know, something for math. This is something for language arts. This is something for science. Cool.
Yep. Oh my gosh, across all subjects. Yeah. There's so many. It's like once you know the basic idea, okay, I can do this. Okay. Now I can use it for so many more things. The things you can do. You can also create self-checking activities. So say there's like a question on it and then maybe you have like two buttons, true or false, or yes and no, or maybe you have a multiple choice down at the bottom and then they click the right answer or whatnot. And then based on what they click on, it'll either say they're right or wrong, or lead to slide with more information if they're wrong to say, do this instead because you got it wrong and now go back and try it again. It's really cool. So students can have a little more control of their learning.
A little more ownership. And we homeschool our four kids. And so I'm always looking for those because we'll do math together in the morning. And then, you know, in the afternoon, they have some of their work that they can do on their own. But things like this are things that like I could set up and set them free, you know, with something like that. So that's really cool. Oh, I love it. Okay, so Nearpod, Google Slides, what else?
Canva. So I love Canva, and I feel like this is a wider known for really creating beautiful, visual, engaging slides. And along with Canva, you can have some fun games and like drag and drop elements within your slides. So say you have like a sorting activity, and maybe you're teaching mammals versus non-mammals. And then you can have all the pictures of different animals to the side. Then as your students tell you which one is which, you can drag and drop it to the right category on your slide.
That's really cool. All right, neat. I haven't done much with Canva slides, to be honest. I mean, I just use it to create stuff for, you know, social media and things like that. And sometimes worksheets. Ton of great worksheets in there, which you can then edit and stuff like that. But I love that, you know, these are online versions and virtual applications of the same.
There are templates already for you, like the worksheets. You can just search. Maybe there's something you have or can use, or you can tweak it to fit exactly what you need. So you don't have to start with a blank slate. You can totally.
I mean, who wants to sit there and like click underscore 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 to like make a name place? No.
Yes.
Like
again,
camping. I don't know. I guess this student was camping for real, but like our lesson was on camping too. So it's like, how perfect. And I found some camping worksheets on Canva to like cut out their items that they were going to take and then write why they were going to bring them. But there's so much on there. I mean, that's the thing. I could just easily flip, the title or a few questions to make it a little bit more personalized for this group.
It's awesome.
Okay, so let's review. Nearpod, Google Slides, Google Slides and Canva. And then what else is there?
Games. Also game sites you can use. And my top three favorite are Blooket, Kahoot, and Gimkit.
Okay.
And within these sites, free to create an account and to host these games. And there are question sets already made that you can use. So just search, math questions or search questions on a story or whatnot, see what pops up. And then you can tweak them if you need to fit your lesson better, or you can create your own questions. So they're, specifically really geared towards what you are teaching. And they're really easy to create. The reason why I like these is because as they're answering questions, there's like a little mini game they're playing. So for example, Blooket, one of my students' favorite games is called Crypto Hack. So they have to answer a question. The game starts. They choose a password and it's just computer generated. They just pick one at random. And then the game starts. They're answering questions. And then after they answer the question correctly, they have three question marks they can choose from. It doesn't matter which one. Pick one at random. And then this is where their crypto comes in. So like they're mining money or whatever. I have students asking, what is crypto? I'm like, it's online money. That's about all I know. Here's your point. You want it.
Yeah.
So they get their points, or they can find there's a hack button. And this hack button allows them to pick someone else's password in the group that we're playing with. And if they guess their password right, they kind of take some of their points.
Ooh.
It's really fun. They are so excited to play the game. They are so willing to answer these questions or practice whatever you're teaching. And again, it's that instant, they know they either got it right or they know they got it wrong. So they don't keep practicing the wrong way.
Okay, that is four. Last one, the most unlikely one, in my opinion. I convinced me, how am I going to use Google Sheets to have a game?
So Google Sheets is really, really cool. And a lot of people stay away from it. But once you know how to use it for like even a few activities, it's really easy. So I recently just created this activity, and it's a self-checking activity. So I have a list of 10 questions to answer. So you can see the questions, and then another column for them to write their answers after they solve it. Mine's division. So they'll answer, like say the first one is 10 divided by 5. So they're going to type 2. If they got it right, the box will turn green. So they know it got it right. And then on the columns next to it, it's going to reveal a picture. So if they got it right, then that first line, just tiny little sliver of a picture will show up. So they have to answer all the questions in order to see the whole picture.
Oh my gosh. Okay. Wow. Well, I think maybe I should confess, like in the last month, I learned how to do conditional formatting. But that's it. So if two, then green, essentially. I mean, this is the, algorithms that we give to different computers and things to make stuff happen. So very cool. Okay. Wow. But that is so
cool.
Wow. But if, like you said, if we can figure this out, these little kind of first steps, then it's infinitely adaptable, essentially. So that's really cool.
Yep.
Oh my gosh. Okay.
It's so cool.
You're blowing my mind with all this, but the idea here is that you can use free tech to gamify your classroom. There are lots of different levels of what this could look like. For some of us who have stuck with Nearpod for the longest time, I love it, but I do want to learn some other things and I want to bring some other things in. So these are really good ideas. So I will link all of these in the description of the video, but you have a beautiful Teachers Pay Teachers store. And I need to know, number one, like what can we find in there? Because a lot of people maybe think Teachers Pay Teachers, worksheets, games, book studies. I use a lot of book studies from Teachers Pay Teachers, things like that. But you've got digital products on there. So talk to us about what is in your TPT store and how we might be able to use that as online teachers, not just teachers in the classroom.
Mm-hmm. So my store is totally geared toward games, digital games, and I have games like specific math. So you will find games specific to math and templates. So you can take this template and tweak it and use it however you need to fit your subject. So I have done all the work. So for like that hide and seek game, I've done all the work. I've linked all the slides. I've created it. All you have to do is plug in your own questions. I had like a Jeopardy game. I have done all the work. So all you have to do is questions and answers, and then it's good to go and you can click it and play it in your classroom because you want to make your life simple as a teacher because, you know, you have this much time. So templates, that's my goal, is that I've done all the work for you so you can save time and create engaging classes for your students.
You have kind of recently developed a course, which is really exciting. It's called Gamify Your Classroom, right? Talk to us about that. What would be your first suggestion to someone who's looking to gamify their classroom? What would you say to them? And then maybe tell us a little bit how we can find your course.
So first thing is to find what you can do and with the tech you're comfortable with. So like if you're comfortable with Google Slides, you know how to make Google Slides. How can we take that further to create this memory game, that hide and seek game, so we can expand there? And then you're ready to open up your world.
Very cool.
Yeah, so a lot of stuff like starts to just overlap. So number one, to start with what you're comfortable with and we'll grow from there. And the second thing is start messy. Mm-hmm. It's not going to be perfect and that's okay. Your students want to have fun. So if your slides don't look perfect, it's okay. Use them anyway. Your students, they're not going to care if the color scheme's not right or whatnot. And don't be afraid to start. It's new, but like Nearpod, if you've never used Nearpod before, don't be afraid to start because it's scary or there's a lot of options to use because it's really cool, really cool tool. My favorite thing with the course, I go over everything we've talked about is in my course, actually.
Cool.
And one other thing, there are digital escape rooms. I teach you how to create a digital escape room in there in my course as well. But we'll go over the basics. So from very beginner, Nearpod, Canva, Google Slides, games, to this is how you create these really fun games. My goal is to make tech simple for teachers so we can start, so everyone can start using it in creating classes that their students are going to love.
So that's huge. Okay. Well, I'm so excited for people to keep learning about these things. So step one, check out some of these tools that we've talked about today. Check out Natalie's CPT store and perhaps her course, get in touch with her. So we can find you, I think, at the EdTech Wizard, correct? And you've got some awesome resources on there. And a great YouTube channel, as I mentioned before. I learned about Nearpod from you. So, and a little buddy there. Hello, little friend.
Hello.
Hi, cutie. Oh my goodness. Oh, I love it. Well, thank you so much, Natalie, for being here and for sharing your expertise with us.
Thank you for having me. It's fun to share. I love helping teachers to use technology because you can use it for so much. It's so cool.
Yeah. And save us time to spend more time at home with these precious babies.